of view. Directly hostile and the movement difficult. The Cylinder 2 variant is played today.
So it can fire on infantry
quite
or
tough.
Now the next vehicle there is something really quite unusual for tanks, it's an M110. Another thing, while we're looking at American tanks, you'll find that during the Second World War,
and they call their tanks type tank. So this is a Type 59 tank, which is therefore basically a Chinese copy of a Russian T-54 tank.
Quite an effective all-round vehicle. It's really too late, much more. And after the war, nothing is flipped by the tank. Well, the next Centurion we're showing you is actually although it looks like a conventional gun tank, it's the last of the Centurion.
Back in the 60s, by a British team, and they were putting together, they were trying to work out what's the best way of defeating incoming projectiles, and one of the things they came up with,
really more of a reconnaissance vehicle, quite fast, they ran a lot of them without the turrets.
Good wide tracks, ideal on the Russian front where you've got mud, snow, very few metalled roads. But in the end, being the Germans, they thought they could go one better, and they end up building the Panzer tank as the Fury. And we've left all the kit on it, so it looks like it's kitted out as it was in the film.
It's worth pointing out actually that the Sherman, they had a version with the 48 in it, which was probably the most reliable of all. The worst of them is always said to be the version 75mm with the same turret and the same suspension. So although they are distinctly different, you can tell they're Sherman.
Well, it's kept in running order. You may see some photographs in older books. Sometimes it was painted, as sadly some of our vehicles still are actually, in rather erroneous colours. But this has now been put back to the colour scheme. This particular model, the L, has got a much more powerful, higher velocity 50mm gun. Again, at least twice, we think. And the original Maybach HL210 engine, which we still have in the museum, was sectioned as a teaching aid. So we actually had to use a HL230 engine that we had a spare, and that was what was refurbished over time. Many ups and downs in that process. US armour supported by infantry is following up the airstrike with a quick attack against the German positions in order to maximise the shock effect on the defenders.